Welcome to MyGayToronto.com. This is Jamie Ebbs and you are watching In Focus. Today's guest is Suzanne McRury, a Canadian painter who has had showings all over North America. In your bio, it states that in 2004, your move to Toronto helped free your work, making it more abstract. In what capacity would you say Toronto impacted your work?
I would say that coming to Toronto let me let go of a lot of old things. And just to try new things, like when you move to a new city, you can kind of become a new person. I think that's what happened with my art. It became its own new entity. And I got away from a lot of the old confines that I had within my own stuff. So it was a lot more free.
In your opinion, how does your queer identity affect the way your work is perceived by the general public?
I don't know if I really have a queer identity. I think that even with my new stuff, I don't even title my new pieces. I just give them a color title. So I really don't want people to judge my stuff based on who I am. Obviously it comes out later and that's all great. And I'm getting recognition also being a queer artist, but I would like people to look at the art and make their own judgments rather than it being about me or about what I initially perceived as my piece or to give any ideas. So it's really, I don't think my queer identity has much to do with my art, other than that it's part of me and that, I'm queer. So that's about all I could say.
What genre do you think best describes the work that you make?
Genre. I'm an abstract artist, but my favorite artists are surreal artists, first and foremost being Salvador Dali. And I actually think, like, looking through even what I have gathered on my website, you can kind of see a progression that is reminiscent of where I've drawn from him and also Picasso. And I think that both of those artists went through a lot of big changes in their careers. And so I would say that maybe I'm an abstract surreal artist, if that's actually an actual thing.
What are specific hallmarks of your style and how do you think that has changed from when you first got out of art school till now?
Well, the stuff that I do now is very much mixed media, which my earlier work wasn't, and now I use resin as well. But one of the biggest compliments I got from the AGO was that even though I use resin, it's not as a finishing piece, it's part of one of my mediums. So that's like one of the new techniques that I've worked on, and that's pretty, you know, the different way that I've gone is trying new mediums and getting out of my old, you know, my old holes and, you know, away from the schooling. I do apparently everything the wrong way or the backwards way. That's how what I was told. So I kind of don't really think it fits in its own little mold.
Ever dabble in other mediums separately on their own, or do you usually combine them in a hybrid with your paintings?
No, I pretty much, what I do is what you see. I go through my own process with every piece. I don't do separate stuff. I don't do photography or anything like that. Or I don't focus on any other talents that I may or may not have. I don't know, I just, what it is what it is. And I think a lot of it is a process, my emotional process too with piece. Like I go through, I hate it, I love it, I work on it, I go back to it, and that's kind of like what happens in your life. Like, it's this big battle all the time.
In 2008, you said that you took a month-long tour in Europe, just touring and looking at art. I'm going to Paris in August, and do you have any must-sees at the Louvre or any place?
Hopefully you're not going during the French holiday, which, so everything is closed. Well, not everything, the Louvre is still open, but a lot of things are closed in France. The Louvre, I mean, you can see everything, though you could be in the Louvre for days and days and days. What I loved about Paris and France, like we took the train through the countryside, and just a lot of the nature and the surroundings and the history there, and just the, if you've only lived in North America, you never see the things that you see there, and the, I think like mostly the history and how things have are so unchanged, but still evolving. And I don't know, that trip really meant a lot to me. We went to Salvador Dali's hometown, we went to Picasso's museum, we went to the Prado in Madrid. Every day was a different gallery. And I think just being in Europe is something of that. And when you think back to, like, that's their creative genius, and that these people that you admire or look up to were also sitting in the same place or at the same cafe and everything else, it's kind of inspiring.
Do you have any upcoming showings or expos that the viewers can see your work at?
I have a few pieces coming up, 2 to 3 new pieces coming up through the AGO, and that will be at the Art Rent Sales and Rentals Department. I had 4 pieces there previously, and they've gone, so that's promising for me. And I have a few pieces at another place in the village, well, just off the village, Fire on the East Side, and they have been gracious enough to keep a rotation going there. And I'm trying to find a home gallery here, other than the AGO. Not that I'm scoffing at the AGO, because that's a pretty great thing. But yeah, that's it for now.
Where do you see yourself 10, 20 years from now?
Hopefully not living here. I hope that Heather, my partner and I, live either in Europe or New York for a few years, and then I would love to retire to Mexico. And that's where I'm actually my new series that I'm working on, a lot of the inspiration comes from. It's just one of the most beautiful places, and either that or we'll be in the country with 100 cats and 50 dogs somewhere, but hopefully just doing my stuff all the time.
Thank you, Susan, and thank you for watching MyGayToronto.com. This is Jamie Ebbs with InFocus.